Hello students, my name is Anup Kumar Dutta. Today in my YouTube tutorial video of the series of educational videos on NCERT mathematics, which is completely free to you, I have just taken the question number 5 from the exercise 4.3 of your book class 10 under quadratic equations NCERT mathematics. Now let us see what the question says. In a class test, the sum of Cephalis marks in mathematics and English is 30. Had she got 2 marks more in mathematics and 3 marks less in English, the product of their marks would have been 220. Find her marks in the 2 subjects. That means we have to determine the marks obtained by Cephali in the class test in the 2 subjects, namely in mathematics and in English, under the 2 conditions that if we add the marks obtained by Cephali in the subjects, namely in mathematics and in English, then in that case the additional product comes to be equal to 30. And condition number 2, that if Cephali had got 2 marks more in mathematics, then the marks actually she got in the class test in the subject mathematics and 3 marks less in English than the marks actually obtained by Cephali in the class test in the subject English. And if we had tried to find out the multiplication product of these 2 marks, in that case we would have got the multiplication product of these 2 marks to be equal to 210. So to do this sum, let us proceed in this way. Write in this way. Let Cephalis marks in mathematics is equal to X. Therefore, according to question, Cephalis marks in English is equal to 30 minus X. If we consider the marks obtained in mathematics to be X, then in that case Cephalis marks in English will be 30 minus X, because the sum of these 2 marks is equal to 30. After this, write in this way. Again, according to question, now this time we will follow the condition number 2 given in the question, So if we do so, we will get X plus 2, which is the increased marks obtained in the subject mathematics, into 30 minus X minus 3, which is the marks deducted marks obtained in the subject English, is equal to, according to question, 210. This again implies X plus 2 into 27 minus X. If we deduct 3 from 30, we will get 27, is equal to 210. This again implies 27X, if we do calculation, between these two terms we will get 27x minus x square plus 54. If we multiply 27 by 2, we will get 54 minus twice x is equal to 210. This again implies x square minus 27x minus 54 plus twice x plus 210 is equal to 0. Multiplying both sides by minus 1 and at the same time transposing this term 210 to the left hand side, we will get this line. This again implies x square. If we do calculation between these two terms, we will get minus 25x. If we do calculation between these two terms, we will get 210 minus 54. 10 minus 4 is equal to 6. 5. If we bring down 1, we will get 156. Plus 156 is equal to 0. So we have got a quadratic equation here in which AC is equal to 156. Now if we want to get the factors of 156, we will get 3 5 is 15, 3 2 is 6, 2 2 is 4, 2 6 is 12, 2 13 is 26. Now if we consider these three factors and multiply them, then we will get 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12. And if we take this factor 13, and if we multiply these two factors, we'll get 156. Now this middle term can be replaced by minus 12x minus 13x. So if we proceed, that again implies x square minus 12x minus 13x plus 156 is equal to 0. This middle term minus 25x has been replaced by minus 12x minus 13x. Now that again implies if we take x as common, we will get x minus 12 minus 13. If we take minus 13 as common, we will get here x minus, if we multiply 12 and 13, we get 156, which is here 156. Now if we take 13 as common, we will get here 12. So it will be minus 12 is equal to 0. This again implies x minus 12 into x minus 13 is equal to 0. After this, write in this way. Therefore, either x minus 12 is equal to 0 or x minus 13 is equal to 0. If we consider this relation, then in that case, the value of x comes to be equal to 12. Or if we take this relation, in that case the value of x comes to be equal to 13. After this, write in this way. Now when x equal to 12, write in this way, cephalis, when x equal to cephalis max in mathematics is equal to 12 cephalis max in English is equal to 30 minus x. In place of x we'll put 12 here, 30 minus 12. If we deduct 12 from 30, we will get 8 here. 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Then when x equal to cephalis max in mathematics is equal to this time 13 cephalis max in English is equal to 30 minus 13, which is again equal to 10 minus 3, 7, 2 minus 1, 17. So these are the answers. So these are the answers. Write in this way. It will spare a little bit time to you. So this is all for today. Why not? Of course, I will expect your kind likes, dislikes, comments, subscriptions, and clicking on the bell icon. Thank you.